My name is Mark McConnell. I'm a derivatives consultant with Provident Risk Management, a company providing turnkey outsourced interest rate hedging solutions to community banks. Today, we're going to talk about how all banks can manage interest rate risk using swaps and caps. Banks are in the business of managing interest rates, both on their balance sheet and for their customers. Interest rate risk in loans, deposits, fixed income securities. Often these interest rate risk challenges conflict. In the current environment, banks want to increase asset sensitivity by making variable rate loans. At the same time, borrowers are keen to lock in long-term fixed rates. Off-balance sheet tools such as swaps and caps allow banks to enhance their traditional on-balance sheet portfolio management strategies. This presentation will introduce simple hedging concepts for banks and the risk management solutions they need to support a hedging program. First, we'll take a look at portfolio or asset hedging. This can cover hedging fixed income securities, loan pools, or mortgage-backed securities. In this first example, a bank wishes to hedge a fixed income security. When we approach this problem, we follow four basic steps. Firstly, we define the strategy. Then, identify the most favorable accounting treatment. We manage the credit and documentation risk. And finally, we analyze the market risk associated with the transaction. Here, our strategy is to hedge the change in value of an asset in response to changes in the long-term LIBOR swap rate. We will qualify this swap as a fair value hedge to ensure changes in the market value of the swap will not impact earnings. We will do a pre-trade and post-trade analysis to ensure the hedge will be highly effective and qualify under hedge accounting rules. Then we will negotiate credit terms and ISDA documentation. Here you can see a screen from Fair Value Insight. The notional amount of our hedge is $25 million, matching the principal amount on the bond. The term is 10 years. Under the swap, we'll pay a fixed rate of 3.25, and that's paid semi-annually, matching the coupon on the bond. We will receive 1 month LIBOR plus a spread of 33 basis points. The floating rate payments will be made monthly. The swap has effectively converted this fixed income security to a variable rate basis. As LIBOR increases, the cash flows on the swap will increase. At the same time, we've hedged the market value of the asset. Any increase in term LIBOR swaps will cause the market value of the swap to go up, offsetting a decline in the market value of the bond. We mentioned earlier four basic steps to building a hedge strategy. The fourth step was to analyze market risk. Here we will stress test the swap to model changes in the fair value of the swap under different market conditions. We can see the changes in the value of the swap as rates go down 50 basis points, up 100 basis points, or up 200 basis points. For example, if rates move up 100 basis points, the market value of the swap will increase by $2.108 million. If rates go down by 50 basis points, the swap will lose $1.142 million in value. Next, we're going to take a look at liability hedging. On the liability side of the balance sheet, we use swaps and caps to manage funding costs on deposits, home loan advances, trust preferred securities, and CDs. In this example, we will look at hedging a deposit program indexed to LIBOR. Our goal will be to limit exposure to rising LIBOR rates. To qualify for hedge accounting, we will identify a pool of deposits with uniform characteristics that will allow us to create a highly effective hedge. In this example, we have a pool of $50 million in deposits linked to LIBOR. We will hedge the first $25 million of deposits in the pool. The hedge will qualify as a cash flow hedge. We model three different interest rate caps. Cat premium will be amortized in accordance with the FASB guidance, which will result in a backloading of the premium. Focusing on the 3-year cap, we have a strike rate of 2.2%. If LIBOR rises above 2.2%, the seller of the cap will reimburse our bank for its monthly interest expense on $25 million above 2.2%. The bank has essentially purchased insurance against rates rising above 2.2%. At Provident Risk Management, we do a lot of work to support hedging programs for commercial loans. We use FinCAS Fair Value Insight and our own transaction manager system to support two hedging programs. Firstly, we support programs where banks use a back-to-back swap book to execute swaps with commercial borrowers and then hedge the risk on those swaps with dealers or home loan banks. For those banks, we support sales and marketing, credit and operations. Is the documentation, pricing, execution, and reporting. For banks making fixed rate loans and hedging those loans individually, we focus on hedge accounting, loan documentation, pricing, execution, reporting, as well as ISDA documentation and counterparty credit risk. Most of our banks prefer to make variable rate loans. Some will not make any fixed rate commercial loans at all. In today's market, many borrowers want to lock in a low, long-term fixed rate. In this example, we meet the objective of the bank and the borrower by combining a variable rate loan with a swap. Firstly, we make a loan at LIBOR plus 400 basis points. Secondly, the bank executes the swap with the borrower. Under that swap, the bank pays LIBOR plus 400 basis points, and the borrower pays a fixed rate of 5.85. From the borrower's perspective, the LIBOR plus 400 payments cancel out, and he is left paying 5.85 fixed. The bank passes the 5.85 fixed from the borrower to its hedge provider and is left earning LIBOR plus 400 basis points. A few key points to notice for commercial borrower swaps. Firstly, the swap must match the principal, amortization, and payment terms of the loan. The two offsetting or back-to-back swaps eliminate market exposure for the bank. There is no hedge accounting designation for these swaps, and accounting is very simple and straightforward. Banks use back-to-back swap programs to manage rate risk on larger commercial loans, to provide greater product flexibility to their commercial borrowers, to allow them to support credit-based loan pricing, and to generate fee income. In the swap example we just saw, the swap was struck at a rate of 5.85. We can see from this report that the par or mid-market swap rate was 5.70%. This resulted in fee income to the bank of $23,599 or 15 basis points. In this example, we use Fair Value Insight's Credit Value Adjustment module to ensure we meet fair value accounting rules. We adjust the market value of the swap for credit risk. Here we can see a credit charge of $2,188 is the credit charge we calculate for this particular interest rate swap. That calculation is based on our internal credit grades for this particular loan. We also use Fair Value Insight to calculate potential credit exposure to our borrower under the swap. Here you can see we've calculated a maximum peak exposure of $241,096 under this particular swap transaction. I'd like to take a minute to talk about the importance of independent valuation. Independent market valuations allow a bank to verify dealer pricing, to carry out independent analysis of credit and market risk, also to model potential strategies and to meet auditor requirements. An independent pricing service should use standard models, provide for open access to models, documentation, and data, should be able to meet FAS 133 and 157 requirements. A system should support credit exposure calculations and should provide for reporting on demand. To calculate a swap rate, a dealer will look at the following components: the treasury curve, swap spreads, internal credit charges for the counterparty, and then, of course, a dealer markup or dealer revenue. Each component of a swap price can be calculated and should be verified. A bank considering using interest rate swaps faces many new challenges: hedge accounting, valuations, is the documentation, credit risk management. Provident Risk Management and FinCAS Fair Value Insight together address all of these challenges. Banks should not reinvent the wheel when they begin an interest rate hedging program. They should adopt proven best practices to provide for policies and procedures, independent valuations, credit and documentation management, and independent analysis and advice. That brings our introduction to hedging to an end. Please look out for upcoming webcasts, which will provide a step-by-step review of commercial loan swaps, balance sheet hedging and hedge accounting issues, and credit-adjusted valuations and credit exposure calculations. For more information, you can contact FinCAD at info@fincad.com. You can contact Provident Risk Management at info@providentrisk.com. Or you can call me directly, Mark McConnell, 704-552-3881. If you have any questions or comments, we look forward to receiving them and getting back to you.